Hi, today review on teardown of these two things I found at the flea market. They are very old instrumentation bricks for electronics lab made by the AOIP brand. It is a very old French company still in business, and they make precision measuring instruments mostly. So these bricks made from Bakelite are probably from the 60s. I remember using them at school, and the professor was really scared of having us dropping them because they were really, really extra expensive back in the time. So they are modular design like so, and they came in a whole bunch of different flavors, and you can stack them like this to make a nice grid of devices. And you could also couple the rotary things as the button here with gears in order to synchronize movements between several modules. So we have here a resistor decade times 10 and some kind of weird galvanometer, but this is not working. It seems the movement is stuck in by some way. So in here you can see the old AOIP logo made in Paris. Well, at least the company central offices were in Paris. Up to 110 ohms at 0.25 ohms. Schematic here on the side. So sadly this one is missing fit. But maybe I can use the box from the other one. I will see if it is possible to have a nice thing, as the other thing is not working anyway. So we will check first this, if it is any good. So sadly I am missing precision measuring instruments. So I will use my old trusty multimeter with some leads. I did double the leads in order to minimize their internal resistance. And we will see what we get. Let's do it like so. It is a little bit messy. Ohms, it will be better. So we have here 0.1 ohms. It is the resistance of the wires and resistance in the switch. Here we have brass switch, wiper switch, as you can see here. Very old school, as you can see on old equipment. So I think it will deserve a little bit of cleaning. It will be useful. I did undo the set screw a little bit. This is why you can remove the button so easily. So if I turn this, slowly enough we get 10 ohms, then 20, 30. So as far as my ohmmeter goes, it seems really good, but it is not a precision instrument by any means, so sadly, but so far I do not see any problem here. Maybe you can get a little bit better result by cleaning the contacts. And these banana plugs here also are not very shiny, little bit oxidized. So, but it seems to be working quite nicely, this thing. And I remember that it came in a whole bunch of flavors, the variable capacitors, resistors, inductors, little voltmeters and stuff like so. You could combine to do your experiments. Okay, so on this is some kind of galvanometer. There is a setting button here, but it does nothing. Here it seems there is a locking button for the mechanism and just two banana jacks. So first we will open this one. So I need a screwdriver. So this one is fairly easy to open. Just a deal of Sorry, I have no time to put the fancy stuff in my video for copyright and such, so this bit of paper will do the job for now. So here is what we have inside, very straightforward. Each contact, the brass contact is connected to a wire wound resistor. They are connected together at the other side with a copper piece on the EV solder job, as you can see. Standoff for the screw. Banana jacks with a thick, maybe silver coated copper, or tin copper at least. Bar here, rigid bar. The 0 ohm resistor is just a piece of wire. In the box we have pretty much nothing, some kind of model number here. So a nice crack here, you cannot see it, but it is cracked because of the shock it got, sadly. For some reason there is a green sticker here. So this is for this one. I will reassemble it. So here is a label on the side, so it is good to make it match the banana jacks. So for this one, this is all that we have. So for Soli, it was very expensive back in the time for just a box of Bakelite, in fact, and some resistors. But they were all handmade with love by all dudes with grey beards. So, and this one, what do we have inside? We have an, yeah, oddly enough, we don't have a screw, we have a nut. And it looks like I do not have a matching key. Yes, no. I'm not sure if it is turning or not, this thing. I did open it previously, but I do not remember which tool I did use. In fact, it is a little bit offset in the hole here, so you cannot really use any. Oh, it will, I guess the player will do the job. And now maybe I can use my, where did I put it? Okay, I did just lose one thing here. Ah, here it is. And now I can open it. Unscrew this. Okay, so this is exactly the same kind of case, as you can see. No surprise inside, it is the same. Here is what we have. We just have two banana jacks. Big U-shape magnet. On the old school galvanometer movement. Not here this delicate interesting piece for the case screw in made in brass. Required a weird shape. Very interesting. So probably on the made one at a time on mills, on a mill. No CNC back in the time. Yes, you can see all the tool marks from the milling. Quite impressive piece, this one. And yes, here we have the... I do not remember if I can open it easily, but in fact we have nothing. We just have the dial here, magnet, and the galvanometer movement. It is all. But it is interesting, particularly for this piece here, which is quite quite nice, and I do not remember how it was like so, I guess. Yes. So very nicely made back in the time. So they still pop up from time to time on eBay, these things. You can still find them because, in fact, they made a lot of them. Each school had them in their physics labs. Or maybe they did. It was used in professional labs also. So there's still a lot around, but sadly, as you can see, you did see, it is bakelite, so it is very easy to break them. If you let them fall, it will break. It's a very brittle material. Okay, so interesting little devices. I will, if I get the opportunity to get more of them, maybe I will get more. Because they're cool and they can be useful, in fact. As this resistor network is perfectly working, so it might be useful to get more of them. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.